The new version of Godot is here, and this time, it's a big one. Godot 4.3 comes with a lot of incredible new features, quality of life improvements, and visual changes. So let's take a look at some of the highlights of this version. The project page had yet another look change, with new icons and buttons now at the top. Now when you create a project, it will now automatically create a new folder for that project. And you can also enable Godot to automatically check for updates with the settings menu. When the new version is ready, it will be displayed at the bottom. Now, let's start with the editor changes. First, there was a lot of usability and quality of life changes. From very small things like highlighting the mouse over the top menus, to bigger things such as the ability to finally put the file system dock at the bottom of the screen, which is great for putting assets into the scene. And you can also drag files across other panels. And now all of them have a shortcut to quickly switch between them. Besides that, you can now completely close any dock or panel, and reopen them using the editor.menu. We now also have the option to have the panels be displayed as only icons or text with icons. Toggling editable children can now be done with a shortcut. You can set it up within the editor settings and quickly toggle editable children. Renaming multiple nodes at once is now natively supported. Simply select them and rename to change all of their names. The behavior of adding new nodes has changed. Now new nodes will be added as siblings of the selected node. This makes it a lot easier when you want to put all new nodes inside the same parent. And you can still hold shift to add a node as a child. Grids can now be set individually. Each viewport can have its own grid turned on and off. Sometimes, you might want to group objects together with a new parent node, but this results in the parent node position being at the center of the world, given a bad offset. To help with that, you can now go into the editor settings and enable center node on reparent. With this, the new parent position will be the average position of its children, which is great for grouping objects together. You don't need to click the small arrow to open and close nodes, and you can safely click anywhere on the left of it, which is much better. Now let's take a break from usability and take a look at some of the new 2D features. Tile maps had a big change, and they are now used as tile map layer nodes. You can convert your old tile maps by selecting them, and inside the tile map panel, click on the tool icon and select Extract Tile Map Layers. This will create a new tile map layer node for each of the old tile map layers. The new system has each layer as its own node, which is easier to visually see the layers and more in line with Godot OS. Everything still works the same. And you can quickly switch between layers by pressing Esc to deselect the node and clicking on a tile to select the node it is in. This makes switching between layers even faster than before. Baking navigation meshes can now easily work on all layers and not just the first one like before. Navigation obstacles can now affect amp mesh baking. Just draw the shape and enable Affect Navigation before baking it again. We also have a new Parallax 2D node to replace the old Parallax background and Parallax layer nodes. Just create a new Parallax 2D node and put sprites inside of it. Set the repeat size parameter and change how many times it repeats. You can add Parallax nodes for each background layer and set different scroll scales to them to create the Parallax effect. The world boundary collision shape has now got a new gizmo, with a nice arrow to indicate its direction. And it is now easier to rotate multiple sprites at once. You can press Shift-V with several sprites selected to create a temporary rotation pivot, displayed in blue. That will now be used to rotate all the sprites without changing their original pivot points. Animated sprites now have the ability to select multiple frames at once. And we now have global groups to better organize node groups. The Project Settings Global tab is now where you can create your autoloads, as well as the new global groups. Creating them is very simple, and you can easily see what groups are global or local to the scene when enabling groups. This new version is also packed with a lot of stability and performance upgrades. A lot of work was made to prevent scene corruption. Godot now won't try to preload cyclic dependencies from code, and you can now load scenes even if you have missing resources, in case you deleted something by mistake. UFBX is now part of Godot, which is really fast. This allows Godot to import FBX out of the box. We also have some initial support for DirectX 12. That can be changed in the project settings. Web builds now support single threads, making it finally possible to run web games inside macOS and iOS again, as well as better support for hosting your games. Now servers don't need to have shared array buffer support enabled to run games. Godot builds now has and uses binary tokens for scripts by default. What this does is tokenize your script files and strip them of comments before putting them inside your game's executable. This can make scripts run slightly faster and also has the side effects of making your games a bit harder to decompile. Packed arrays are now saved in Base64 encoding. This can significantly reduce scene sizes and make them load faster when dealing with large sets of values, which can be the case for large tile maps. GDScript had a few upgrades as well. You can now use export custom to add custom hits like suffixes to properties. And we now have code highlight inside the docs, making it much easier to read the examples. The export storage annotation was added. That makes a variable serializable without exposing them to the inspector. This is useful for add-ons when working with subgizmos or other types of resources. And you can also use the isNot keyword to make if statements read better. Audio had great changes in Godot 4.3. Audio clips looping property can now be changed per audio stream player. And we've got three new incredible new additions for making sound in Godot. A audio stream playlist that lets you play music from a list that can be played in order or at random. A audio stream synchronized that can sync and play several audio clips together. Great for making procedural songs and effects. And a really interesting audio stream interactive system. You can set automatic transitions to make your own semi-procedural music. Transitioning from an intro to a looping part of the song, or a high-paced one. You can have automatic transitions, or call them yourself from the code to control the music. It can also remember what is being played at special transitions and return to the previous song. So when a Beowulf music finishes playing, it can return to the previous game music, whatever it was. This system is really fun to work with, but it certainly deserves a video of its own to explain how it works. Going back to the 3D world, Godot 4 now finally have its depth fog back. Now we can easily make that good old PS2 style fog again. The Path 3D node has also got a ton of usability fixes. You can now click individual points and use the transform tool to move them around, making it easier to position them at the correct position. The tilt gizmo is now hidden, and you can enable the tilt change mode with the yellow icon at the top. The transform gizmo will also work with local rotations based on the point's tilt position. Sadly, placing points on Path 3D still doesn't snap to floors, but that's all that's left to make Path 3D very good. The material preview can now have the lights follow the model rotations inside the imported preview. And the material option to see the car native shader code now comes with a proper window and code highlighting. Creating collisions from meshes now have been declared from the mesh menu into its own pop-up window. A new property of the editor theme was exposed that allows custom themes to increase the size of class names. Now you can have a custom theme like this that makes class names bigger, which could make it easier to find properties by class. The option to change editor vsync was added. You can now disable vsync inside the editor to get a more responsive editor. This option is inside the editor settings. The project settings vsync only affects the running game. And it is now easier to tell Godot what panels it opens and closes when running and starting a game. Finally, the visual shader graph had a really good visual overhaul. Nodes are now color-coded and a lot easier to use. Godot 4.3 now have the option to interpolate physics. This makes your game look more responsive by updating the sprite's position between each physics frame. Here's an extreme example with an extremely low physics frame. To enable interpolation, you also need to set jitter to 0. With interpolation turned on, even though the movement is still blocky, the final display looks smooth. So this might help some games look better, in less extreme cases. Animations had a lot of upgrades as well, like the new skeleton modifier 3D, and big stability fixes from the refactor of the previous version, reaching a now stable phase. And finally, we have some big changes. Godot now uses a reverse Z buffer, This allows the depth buffer to have much more precision at no cost of performance. The depth buffer is used to tell object distance from the camera and what to render in front of what. So a better depth buffer can reduce z-fighting. The downside of that is that some shaders will need to be updated after this change. But with the extra precision, Godot will have a better time of rendering overlapping objects and you get more precision to work with your shaders. And finally, compositor effects. You can now hook inside the render pipeline and add your own custom effect passes. It also has the ability to give you motion vectors that tells you what moved in the screen between frames. This allows for new shaders effects that was just not possible before. And more than that, it is now much easier to just add and modify post effects into your games. Horror games will surely have a blast with it. And that's Godot 4.3, the biggest update of Godot 4 yet. Bigger than 4.1 and 2 combined, this update brings a much needed stability to Godot, completing several refactors and stabilization features started with Godot 4. With tons of new contributors, Godot is growing very fast and keeps getting better. Thanks for watching, and until next time.